We are at that time of the day when we would all do some good by listening to some motivational words, and who better than Swamiji to tell us about it. As a Rotarian, I'm truly, truly proud that Swamiji has been awarded with the Rotary Seva Ratna, and he's been conferred the Personal Excellence Award by Rotary International. I'm truly very privileged that he's amongst us today, but I will not stand between you and Swamiji, who is going to come up on stage now. But before that, please, can we have the video?
Swami Sukhabodhananda is the founder chairman of Prasanna Trust. Swamiji is not only one of the most respected spiritual leaders of the country, but also nicknamed as Corporate Guru. His expertise lies in synthesizing ancient wisdom of East and modern vision of West, appealing to both young and old from wide spectrum of society. Swamiji is the author of many bestsellers whose books have sold over a million in more than 111 titles in different languages. His books have made many discover a new way of living life. He makes one realize that if one door closes, another door opens. Life is an opening. His spirituality-based transformative education programs have been rated as excellent and benefited many in the corporate sectors of reputed institutions like banking, finance, industry, armed forces, police, and prestigious business schools like Indian School of Business, etc. Leading industrial houses invite him to conduct in-house workshop for their executives. Swamiji, through his talks and workshops, is impacting the decision makers on inclusive growth, developing skills to bring forth attitudinal change, foster multidimensional growth in an individual and teams as a vision of transforming the country, march towards creating new India. Swamiji has been a sports psychology coach for the cricket team Delhi Daredevils. Times of India, in one of their poll on who talks the best, places Swamiji as the one who tops the list on all counts as the best speaker. Swamiji's English books, O Mind Relax Please and O Life Relax Please, are the top bestsellers in the country and have set a new benchmark in the lives of many. From the Kargil hero, General V.P. Malik, who swore by the inspiring content of the book, to the New York City mayor, who acknowledges its usefulness to diminish work pressure and dealing with New York City's press. Swamiji's book, Manase, Relax Please, has set an all-time sales record in the history of Tamil, Kannada and Telugu books and has been included as a part of curriculum in some of the schools and colleges. Leading personalities have termed that he has revolutionized Tamil literature through his books. Swamiji was invited as a dignitary on five different panels at the World Economic Forum in Davos, Switzerland, and was a special invitee to the United Nations World Millennium Summit of Spiritual Leaders. Swamiji is the second Indian to be honored at the prestigious Lotus Millionaires Intellectual Club at Manhattan, New York. Swamiji was invited as a corporate guru to deliver keynote address on leadership and change management at Gyan Sangam as the star attraction at the Finance Ministry retreat, which was attended by the Prime Minister, Finance Minister, the RBI Governor and senior North Bloc officials, chairmen and directors of various nationalized banks and financial institutions to bring about banking reforms. It was termed as a great success and invited him again as a keynote speaker in Gyan Sangam 2 for bank CEOs. Swamiji's works in audio and video have been transforming the lives of many through Saregama and Times Music. His message on the Astha, Sanskar and many other channels is reaching a wide spectrum of people both in India and overseas. Prasanna Trust, under his inspiration and guidance, runs an orphanage for girls, provides artificial limbs and calipers to people with impoverished background, provides medical aid, offers free ice creaming camp and possible correction through free cataract surgeries, free stent for angioplasty heart procedure for the poorest of the poor, conducts blood donation camps and regular camps of feeding the poor, Prasanna Trust also provides scholarship for students from economically weaker section of the society. Swamiji was awarded Karnataka's Best Social Service Award by SL Group and Z Network. In recognition of his service to humanity at large, Swamiji was awarded Rotary Seva Ratna. Rotary International has conferred Personal Excellence Award for impacting the lives of many. Reva University, Bangalore has conferred Corporate Excellence Award for blending spirituality as a game changer in the corporate world.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Swami Sukhabodhananda. Big round of applause as he takes on the stage. Very warm welcome to you, sir.
Thank you. Good evening. Good evening.
Good evening.
Namaste.
Namaste.
Okay, thank you for inviting me here. I'm sure your Madhya Pradesh must be hungry. It's time for dinner. But anyway, let me start off. It seems a man rushes to the 15th floor. A man rushes to the 15th floor and says, "Sharma, Sharma, your daughter ran away." And the moment this man hears, "My daughter ran away," he feels so frustrated, so despondent, shattered. "Are mere maan chale gaya." He jumps from the 15th floor to commit suicide. And as his body was come to the 10th floor, he realizes he's not married. So how can his daughter run away? I mean, he was an Indian. Right? And as his body was come to the 8th floor, he realizes he has not got a daughter. Without getting married also, you can have a daughter, isn't it? Don't look at me so confused. It appears I am the naughty guy here. Right? Then as his body came to the 4th floor, he realizes he is not Sharma, he is Varma. Friends, when this man was told, "Sharma, your daughter ran away," he jumps. Now, in dictionary, jumping is an action. It's a kriyapad. But in a spiritual dictionary, it is not an action, sir. It is a reaction. It is not a kriya. It is a pratikriya. The first thing that we have, if you have to go from ordinary to an extraordinary, we have to be sensitive and cognizant. Is our action an action or a reaction? Jumping is an action, but actually it is a reaction. The choice that you and I have to make in the course of living is, either it's a reaction, and the opposite of reaction is what? Is response. Pratikriya, and in Sanskrit is called as anukriya. Ordinary it is action, but you make a distinction. Pratikriya is reaction, and response is not a reaction, sir. Right? And therefore, the greatest responsibility for us to be sensitive and alert to be leaders is our action should not be a reaction. Our action should be a response. It is not a pratikriya, it is an anukriya. And therefore, in English, the word responsibility means the ability to respond. For me, please, it doesn't matter how or qualified a person is. If I can have the discipline, the acumen, the acuity to go on responding to the situations of life and not reacting, you find a tremendous sagacity will give a different alacrity in one's life. Now, Sharma, your daughter ran away. First, it is a reaction. What is the content of the reaction? What is the content of the reaction? I know last 15 minutes you can ask me, but in between I'll ask. What is the content of the reaction? Huh? All of you. Good evening. Good evening. Namaste. Now, why do we say good evening? What's the psychology of a good evening? You know, if you study anthropology, you know how a shake hand emerged? When one warrior goes to meet another warrior, I'm not going to attack you, I'm going to extend friendship. And that's how the whole anthropology of a shake hand emerged. So what is the whole psychology of a good morning, good afternoon, good evening? This evening is very good, isn't it? Yes or no?
Yes.
This evening is so good, so colorful. This evening is good. All of you look so bright. This evening is good. Let us recognize it. Let us validate it. Because one of the sickness in living, according to me, we don't validate what we have got. We don't recognize what you have got. You have got a beautiful job, we don't recognize. Beautiful wife, we don't recognize. Neighbor, husband, invariably recognizes. And according to my experiences, one of the sickness of living is we don't validate, we don't recognize what we have got. So therefore, to break this kind of blind spot, this evening is good. Let us recognize it. And if the evening is not good, let us make it good. Isn't it? Now, namaste, all of you. Namaste. Namaste. Now, what is the psychology of namaste? Have you seen some politicians saying namaste? Namaste, one mosquito is crushed. So why do you say namaste now? Shake hand, I say, what is namaste? You are very different from me. I come from Bangalore. You come from somewhere else. You are different from me. But in the space of love, you and I are one. And this oneness, we should attempt to see. And we say namaste. Now, how many of us really mean when we say good morning? How many of us really mean when we say namaste? Most of us, I feel, we don't mean. Good morning, good morning, good afternoon, namaste, namaste. When we don't mean and we do, what is it called in English? Huh? It's mechanical. Yantravat ho gaya. It is very mechanical. So good morning, mechanical, namaste, mechanical. And when it's become mechanical, mechanical, the very quality of your life is tremendously ravaged. And therefore scientists, I'm sure you must have heard different speaks. Now scientists are saying the pathology that humanity is globally going to go suffer along the line is called robo-pathology. Robots are going to take over this planet. And why all these people have become robots? All right, and if you become robots, it doesn't make anything. So one of the things we have to be alert is our action mechanical. Sharma, your daughter ran away, jumps, it is a reaction. And the content of reaction, it is yantravat, it is mechanical. And if your content of reaction is mechanical, be it anger, jealousy, upset, frustration, if it is mechanical, what happens? What happens if it is mechanical? And autopilot takes over. When autopilot takes over, you have no control over the reaction. That's when you get upset, frustrated, anger, jealousy. There is an autopilot takes over because it's mechanical, yantravat ho gaya. And therefore an autopilot takes over, we have no control. And we have no control, our whole life gets crushed. So first thing, sir, are we reacting or responding? The more you react, you're mechanical. And the more you're mechanical, it's autopilot. And the more autopilot takes over, you find the reaction gives you tremendous stress. Yes or no, friends? It gives you stress. And when it gives you stress, Lord Buddha very beautifully says, you don't even experience what is, he says. And when you don't experience what is, you may have growth, sir, but there's no profitable growth. I want to be sensitive. All of you are very successful people. See, technologically, we have tremendously grown. Yes or no? Yes. Technologically, we have tremendously grown. But has human consciousness truly grown? I'm happy you're saying this. Right? Human consciousness has hardly grown. Weapons of mass destruction have increased. Nations are more organized in destroying each other. And if another war takes place, Hiroshima, Nagasaki, we know it was not at all required. What is the effect? If a war takes place, this planet Earth is destroyed many times. So there has been growth, but there's not been truly profitable growth. Yes or no, friends? Yes. And it's not been profitable growth. Can I use a little Hindi? Yes. It is said, Arey, patthar ek baar mandir jata hai. Patthar ek baar mandir jata hai, aur bhagwan ban jata hai mandir mein. Or insan bar bar mandar jakar patthar hi rehta hai. Right? We have become a patthar. And therefore it is said, mandir or masjid, kya gazab ki jagah hai? Mandir or? Kya gazab ki jagah hai? Bikhari log bahar bhik mangta hai, aur amir log andar bhik mangta hai. Everything bhik mangta hai. And therefore, have you seen marriages? What has happened, sir? From engagement ring to marriage ring to suffering to enduring. Because one beggar gets married to another beggar. When two beggars get married, beggary increases. And therefore, in so many counsel I do, there is always fear in relationship. There is always fear. And in this fear, sir, with fear, you may grow, but there is no profitable growth. An American comes to the financial capital of our country, which is this, Bombay. And he was shocked to see so many beggars. And the American was shocked, hey, India is growing so many beggars. And that in front of Fox Stock Exchange. He goes to a beggar, give money. All right, that beggar has stretched both hands like this. The American ekdam hairan ho gaya. Hey, why this beggar has stretched both the hands? He asked the beggar, why have you stretched both the hands? He says, business is doing very well. I've opened another branch. But he still is a beggar inside. What type of growth it is? The American got thoroughly confused. He goes to the next person. Fortunately, had one hand stretched. And he was about to give money. And the American said, I've seen you somewhere. The beggar also says, I have seen you somewhere. He was shocked. Means, have you come to New York? He says, no. Today's the first day I'm coming to Bombay. Where have you seen? And the beggar replies, Bombay beggar replies, we are friends in Facebook. So technologically very savvy, but inside, bhikari hai. Sir, is this growth, sir? Ask this question. While there is growth, which all of us are forking, there must be truly profitable growth. Or else your life is always afraid, afraid, afraid. I've seen, please see, rich people afraid, poor people afraid. People are married afraid, people are single afraid. People have one wife afraid, many wives afraid. And when you are afraid, more tension. That's why there's a beautiful Urdu Shari which says, Are kyu dare zindagi mein kya hoga? Kyu? Dare zindagi mein kya hoga? Har waqt kyu sochna to bura hoga? Badhte raho manzilo ko aur hum. Kuch na mila to kya hoga? Tajurba to naya hoga. Tajurba to naya hoga. You'll have an experience. But Buddha says, listen very carefully. I'm saying very subtly to the topic, from ordinary to extraordinary. Buddha says, because of tension and chaos, we don't experience an experience. Buddha's famous name is called as what? What is Buddha's famous name? Huh? Tathagat. Because he taught a meditation called Tathatha. And Tathatha means, Buddha says, experience whatever is. And we don't experience what is. Why? Because Buddha says, the experiencer pollutes the experience. And you experience an experience not according to the experience, but according to the experiencer polluting the experience. Didn't understand? Now I'll come again. Hindi mein bolenga. Anubhav ko anubhav nahi karta hum log. Anubhav kartha aakar, anubhav ko upar pradushit karke, anubhav kartha ka prarup anubhuti hota hai, anubhav ka prarup nahi. This also didn't understand. But doesn't matter. I know your Madhya Pradesh is hungry. Doesn't matter. I'll say it in English. Don't worry. I won't leave you. If you go to a barber, unless he finishes you, he doesn't leave. I'm a spiritual barber. Listen. Right? A Bangalore person goes first time to Mumbai and sits in a taxi and go to Powai. The taxi driver is driving the taxi. The Bangalore passenger, IT fellow, want to ask him a question. He gently taps him on the back. When he taps him on the back, the cab driver, the Bihari cab driver in Bombay, gets so panicky, he goes left, right, left, right, left, right. Asti vyast chale jata hai. The passenger ekdam hairan ho gaya. Maine kya kiya baba, sparsh kiya. 2 minutes he goes haywire, pasina aa jata hai, dil ka dhadkan badh gaya. Then finally he puts a brake and, you know, cools down and turns back and says, for heaven's sake, don't touch me while I'm driving the taxi. The passenger says, in Bangalore, we touch people, we don't pinch people. Then immediately the Bombay taxi drivers, have you seen? Gussa thurant aata hai, thurant kam ho jata hai, like a soda bottle, brrr, and comes down. He cools down and the cab driver turns back and tells the passenger, it is not your problem, it is my problem. The passenger says, what is the problem? Today is the first day I'm driving the taxi. And the cab driver says, 25 years I've been driving a van. Today is the first day I'm driving the taxi. The passenger gets more confused. What is the big difference between a van and a taxi? And the taxi driver says, 25 years I'm doing a van. Today is the first day I'm driving the taxi. And the taxi driver says, in the van, I was carrying dead bodies. So when you touched me, oh, Bhuta Preta touched me. Pause for a moment. Did the taxi driver experience the experience of patting? No. The experiencer means his autobiography of 25 years ka past. The past polluted the present and he experienced the present not according to the present but according to the past polluting the present. Isn't it, friends? In life, we can't see the present as it is. In so many corporate talks, I go. And when I take, I come from an IT hub, Bangalore, so many IT people. When I take IT people, my tension increases. Because any joke I crack, they study my software and hardware. Fellows, don't laugh only. I had to stop my speech and I said, why are you not laughing? He said, why should I laugh? Any question he asked, I said, why? I said, what is your name? He said, why Venkatesh? I told in Tamil, correct kurtunga ba father un peru. Are, I said, to make the marriage work, laugh. Again, he says, why? I said, the rate of divorce among the marketing people are the least. Again, he says, why? He becomes Arnab Goswami, goes on asking, why? All right? When the rate of divorce among the marketing people are the least and IT people are the maximum. Again, he says, why? Then I had to tell him, sir, marketing people, global statistics is 16 to 18 is the hit rate. At least 2 years back, I don't know the latest. 16 to 18 is the global hit rate. So a marketing man knows the hit rate is 16 to 18. So when a customer says no, he'll smile and give the visiting card. So when the wife tells a marketing husband, get lost, he'll smile and give the visiting card. It is his discipline. Whereas a computer person, the wife says, get lost, he'll go to the Googles and look out for options. And that fellow, then he started a little smiling. Sir, even to smile so much of struggle, what type of growth it is, sir? Rabindranath Tagore simply sees a dewdrop on a lotus leaf, poetry comes out. And Kuppaswamy sees Niagara Falls and dysentery comes out. Mera gaav mein paani ne. There's no adbhut rasa at all. Have you seen some people? There's no wow. There's no wow. Any joke also, piles can claim constipated look. Sir, for me to be extraordinary, everything should be a wow. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, everything should be a wonder. Ascharyavat vadati, ascharyavat paschati, ascharyavat chrinoti. Everything should be a wow, wow, wow. If your wife is scolding you, it should be a wow. One of my students says, after doing my workshop and reading your book, Swamiji, whenever my wife scolds me, she is 9th standard fail. What tremendous communication skills she has got. In her nagging, there is pace, pause, pitch, punctuation, voice modulation, open statement, close statement, funnel technique, multiple closes, disarming technique, and also preemptive strike. See everything there. And if your boss is scolding you and if you have adbhuta rasa, wow, how beautifully his mustache goes up and down, wow. Are luft le lo na kidhar bhi. Sir, Lord Krishna in the Gita says, everything should be a wonder. And if everything is a wonder, sir, I see it's extraordinary to live. Extraordinary to live a life. People have no wonderment. You're whole caught up in earning money, 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 money. Ultimately, what happened? Are bina libas aayate jahan mein, bas ek kafan ka kaatar itna safar karna pada. We have come without dress, ultimately go to shamshan. I'm not saying don't earn money. I'm saying, sir, your life for it to be extraordinary, it should be a wow. Walt Disney, so many times he failed, sir. All right, and suddenly he got an idea for Mickey Mouse. Rest is history. Thomas Alva Edison, 900 odd times he failed in creating a bulb. But when he created the bulb and somebody asked him to be a frustrated person, he says, no, 900 odd times I learned how not to create a bulb. So if your state of being is a wow, sir, then everything is a challenge. Everything is a fun. Are you getting, friends? Yes or no? All right, for me, that is extraordinary living, sir. There is growth and there is profitable growth. But some people are in Lucknow, is taking a workshop and somebody told me, Swamiji, I fell in love, Swamiji. I fell in love. Now I know why you are not married. First of all, I told him, who told you to fall in love? Love, you have to rise in love, no? Fellow says, I fell in love. First, that's an error. Love is something to be fallen or risen. Then he says, Swamiji, mazak chod do, Swamiji. Chandni chand se hoti hai, sitaro se nahi. Mohabbat ek se hoti hai, hazaro se nahi. I said, you may be from Lucknow, I am from Bangalore. From Google's only we learn, I said. I said, sitare se aage, jahan aur bhi hai, abhi ishq ka imtahan bhi aur bhi hai. Aur bhi hai. Then therefore, please see, even a love affair has become crushed. Therefore, our love has to be, our love affair should be a matured love. Your love is only like and dislike. If you are doing business, I'm sure most of you are doing business with like and dislike. And Lord Krishna's great message is raga dvesha viyuktaistu vishayan indriyais charanises. Please explore. See, we are living in a platform where problems, worries, hurt, upset, frustration is created. So long you are in that platform, you can't create solution in that platform. If you rise to another platform, please understand, only solutions can happen. In a platform, you are hurt, upset, frustrated. Lord Krishna says, because you are living a life of likes and dislikes. Now, what should it be? Let it be mature love, sir. Now, I'm talking out of love. This, I think, sixth or seventh night, I'm in seven places. I've stayed in seven different states and some in country. Every night, I've been in another state or in a country. And people say, what is the passion? Because when you operate of a love, please understand, it doesn't matter if people clap me or not. I do what I love what I do, because pyar ka jazba naya rang dikha deta hai. Pyar ka jazba naya rang dikha deta hai. Ajnabi chehre ko mehboob bana deta hai. Ajnabi chehre ko bhi mehboob bana deta hai, sir. From like and dislikes, do your work with love. Do your work with love. You will be beyond the platform of like and dislike. And when you transform from like, dislike to love, from love to bhakti, bhakti means devotion, you will see a work. For me, work is a devotion. I'm not a ritualistic man. For me, work is a devotion. Being with people is devotion. And therefore, I'm not tired globally trotting. Seven places in seven different states I am there. All right? I love, it's a devotion for me. And when you can work with devotion, sir, you are extraordinary. Right? And therefore, there's a beautiful Urdu shayari which says, "Arey zindagi mein kya khoya hai ya aur kya paya hai?" Koi puchenge, "Zindagi mein kya khoya hai aur kya paya hai?" Beshak kehna, says this poet, "Jo kuch khoya hai, ve meri nadani thi." Nadani means my stupidity. "Jo kuch khoya hai, ve meri nadani thi, aur jo kuch paya hai, Rab ki meherbani thi." Says. Khoobsurat rishta hai mera aur khuda ka beech, mai zyada mangta nahi, wo kam deta nahi. Jo nahi hai usko gam nahi hai, jo hai kisi se kam nahi hai. Jo nahi hai ye khwab hai, jo hai wo lajawab hai. Whatever is you have got, lajawab hai, no? All of you have got eyes? Why are you doubtfully saying? You have eyes or not, all of you? Say wow. See, that vav has no dham. That's why it's called dham pati. Pati ka dham ni. You, all of you have got eyes? Say vav. You're saying vav because I'm saying. But Miss World hugs you. Wow, wow. Somebody gives you 1 crore. Wow. You're 100 out of 100. But you have got 2 eyes. Is your feeling validating the richness of your eyes? But feeling validates. Miss World hugs you. Feeling validates when you get a medal. Feeling validates when you get $1 million. Yes or no, sir? But is feeling validating that I've got 2 eyes, sir? No, we are validating maybe 4, 5, 6, 7. But it should be 100 to 100. All of you have got kidneys here? Say wow. Wow. Liver? Wow. See, aapka wow mein dam hai kya wo? That means you're not validating. And one of the sickness of living is the feeling is not validating what God or existence has given you. When feelings don't validate what existence or God has given you, that is a most ordinary way of living. But if feelings can validate, right, I've got eyes, wow, I've got legs, wow, then when you do, you become bigger than the situations of life. That is extraordinary, sir. Are you getting, friends? Yes or no?
Yes.
And if you can bring, so life operate from like and dislike is one. Life operate from love is different. Life operate from devotion. Yes, yet another thing, sir. And when you do that, you will find life becomes extremely wonderful. Therefore, it is said, Khuda ehsaas ka naam hai, rahe saamne aur dikhai na de. God is something to be felt. Or else, rahe saamne. For Duryodhana, Krishna was in front. But na dikhai na de. Are you kidding, sir? Yes, no?
Yes.
So you have to see this. Are you seeing it or not?
Yes.
Philosophy in Sanskrit or Hindi is called as what? Darshan Shastra. Darshan means what? Seeing. And if you see, sir, soch ko badalo, sitare badal jayenge. Nazar ko badalo, nazare badal jayenge. Kashtiyan badalne ka zarurat nahi. Dishavo ko badalo, kinare badal jayenge. Change the very direction, sir. So therefore, you have to see the richness of what you have. And if your feeling validates the richness of what you have, life becomes wonderful, sir. And in your working, if you can be free in your perception, free in your perception, then you find your perception becomes bigger than the perceived. But unfortunately, the perceiver pollutes the perception, and you perceive the perceived as an extension of the perceiver and have the illusion you are perceiving the perceived. Can I perceive the perceived without the interference of the perceiver? Sir, you're playing, for example, sports people I teach, right? And the ball is coming. The ball is coming now. When the ball is coming there, and if a person is hitting, for tennis, let us say, hitting the ball, and he's worried, you will I hit the ball? That person is a great person, blah, 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 blah. When he's doing there, your lower self, the self one is operating. When self one of worry, tension, upset is operating, the ball the person is hitting and your mind is worrying, upset, frightened, the self one, your mind, is interfering into the perception of the ball coming. So the perceiver pollutes the perception. So I tell sports people, okay, the ball is coming, silent the self one. In Sanskrit it's called jivatma. Silent it. When you silent that man, allow the self to, the higher self in you, watch the ball, silent the self one, sir. All right? Have trust in your intelligence. When you have trust in your intelligence, the ball is coming. See, so focused on the ball, your intelligence, the core self, will give you the acumen, the acuity to face the ball. But if the self one is going on messing it up, by your worry, upset, frustration, the perceiver pollutes the perception. That's an interfering self. Are you getting, friends? Yes or no? And that is where tension happens in a lot of people. Let's say temple. So therefore, I will say now, if you can right now listen to me, don't bring the self one. In Sanskrit, it's called jivatma. Don't bring it. Silent it. Allow the self two in you, the higher self. Your intuition to see, then you will see, you will not stop at my words. You will see my intent of what I'm saying. And between you and me, there will not be a communication, there will be a communion between you and me. My dog does not know Hindi, Sanskrit, Urdu, English, but whatever I communicate, my dog understands. Because there is a communion, sir. In life, don't bring the worrying self. Don't bring the interfering self one, I said. Don't bring it. Look at your work totally and allow the intelligence to operate, sir. And the intelligence in us will start operating. You may make a mistake, but this intelligence also will correct the mistake. Hand is broken, the doctor sets it, the curing happens within yourself. Are you getting, friends? So therefore, for me, this is extraordinary. Now, I will say, please see very fastly, given the limitation of 45 minutes and question answers you have. Thing there, I'll say the first important thing is you should have a vision in life. Please see, this is Indian martial art. You should have a vision. Vision, power, speed, skill, strategy. For me, this is Indian martial art. I'm a student of martial art. All right, I teach Bhagavad Gita, so I can't go to the war, so I've learned martial art, so I can get the concept of it very far. Now, what I am playing martial art in a corporate context, sir, because it's a war, it's a conflict. Like life, is a conflict between the temptation and what is good to you. Yes or no? It's a conflict. It's an ongoing war. Ongoing war between the temptation and what is good to you. And every moment you have to be alert towards. So too also is a war. A corporate world also is a kind of war which you have to do there. Keeping that. What should be the... I'm applying this in the corporate context. What should be your vision of life, sir? Quickly, what should be your vision of life?
Shut your mind.
All right? Quiet your mind. Very good, sir. In ordinary language, what should people's vision of life is what? Success, 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 success. Isn't it, friends? Yes. Tell me yes or no.
Yes.
You can give me a smart answer, but we are all interested in success, success. I'm not saying you should not be against success. But the Indian culture says, for me, it's extraordinary. More than success, you should have fulfillment in life.
Happiness
also no, fulfillment. I want happiness, I take ganja, dhammaradham, I'm very happy. Thoda sharab piro, dhammaradham. Sir, we say in Sanskrit, fulfillment. Aapuryamanam achalap pratishtam samudramapa pravijanti atvat. Now, there's lack of time for me to do that, read my books, etc. You watch to my YouTube. I've said this, fulfillment is an amalgamation between success and satisfaction. Because many people are successful, but their life is still misery. Elvis Presley, Marilyn Monroe, all very highly successful people, but still their life was miserable. Marilyn Monroe, the most beautiful actress in the history of Hollywood. She had depression, she had money, power, position, name, had multiple affairs, still she was miserable. So is success ka bavajood bhi andar ek daridrata hai. So is success is not the be all and end all of life. All right, success amalgamated with satisfaction. Success is getting what you like, not what your neighbor likes. Getting what you like is success, and liking what you get is satisfaction. If your brain can get what you like and like what you get, there is an amalgamation of both, sir. There is a mysterious fulfillment which happens, sir. And in fulfillment, life is very, very nourishing. All right, there is no vigadhan, there is cherishing. Are you getting, friends? All right, if you only think success, 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 and you do not know how to be satisfied, be happy, then you are lost. In the name of being content, content, content you do, then you are not working on success, there's no creative juices will open up. These are all polarities which appears cannot be polarized. There's a polarization of these polarities. So therefore, first is vision. All of you say vision? So it is fulfillment. All right, now work. When you start working, very interesting, you find, are har pal mein pyar hai, har lambe mein kushi hai, khodo to yaad hai, jilo to zindagi hai. When you start working on this, all right, and therefore first vision, next is power. All of you say power?
Power.
Now what is power? The power is two things. There's a power of commitment, there's a power of complaint. For me, extraordinary is having a powerful vision. That's why, you understand a little Hindi Urdu? That's why there's a beautiful, coming to vision, there's a very beautiful a Sufi fakir who has given this poem. He says, Khwaish aisi karo ki aasman tak ja sako. Khwaish aisi karo ki aasman tak ja sako. Success. Dua aisi karo ko khuda ko pa sako. See the contradiction. Khwaish aisi karo ki aasman tak ja sako, dua aisi karo ko khuda ko pa sako, yu to jeene ke liye phal bahut kam hai, jeevo aisa har phal zindagi pa sako. Live in every way, every moment, har phal zindagi. But hum log zindagi ki talash se bahut dur tak nikal pade. Isn't it? Zindagi ki talash se bahut dur tak nikal pade. Magar zindagi nahi mili. Tajurbe bahut mile. This is the halat of people. In the search of life you go, ultimately you don't get life. You get different experiences, sir. Don't make this vision, sir. Power is come from the power. I'm talking out of commitment. You should listen out of commitment. But we come from complaint, complaint, complaint. And when you come from complaint, please see. Most of people I'm seeing throughout the world, they get hurt when unpleasant words somebody says. Yes or no? Tell me, sir, yes, no.
Yes.
2020, the second greatest killer is depression. What is the use of having all your money and depression? 2020, the second greatest killer is depression. 35% of women are in depression in India. World Health Organization, second greatest killer is depression. Now, I'm asking you, sir, one of the biggest things is people get hurt. Somebody says an unpleasant word, you get hurt. This is a very ordinary way. How can an unpleasant word hurt me? Pause. Somebody calls me a monkey. Does the word wing come like a Scud missile? Dishku create sorrow? Does it happen? Somebody calls a monkey, I have to look this side, look that side, make sure there are no monkeys. Doubly check up myself, sometimes genetical changes can happen. And if I'm sure I'm not a monkey, tell him to go to an ophthalmologist and get your eyes checked up, no? But if somebody says monkey, you say donkey, he says buffalo. Sir, it is not the incidence of life which gives us sorrow. It is your narrative of the incidence of life which gives you sorrow. It is not the incidence of life. Please see, if I can show you a quick note. I'm going fast because I have 45 minutes only. I'm going fast. If you see, very, very important, please understand this. For most of people, you say incidence of life gives you. Please see this now. Now you see, now somebody uses an unpleasant work, because if you don't work this with lot of money, your still life can be frustrated. Lot of success. Some words. Words, when somebody says, I get hurt, my boss, my wife, my ex-wife has said this, I got hurt. When words come and fall, where does it fall in you? In your kidney, liver, or intestines? In your mind, isn't it? Now, what is mind? Quickly, what is mind? Don't say mind your own business, Swamiji. What is mind? Mind is a pure interpretation mechanism. I'm a Hindu, I'll have Hindu interpretation. Christian, Christian. I'm a Muslim, Muslim. Mind is nothing but an interpretation mechanism. I was in Blue Mountains in Australia, my first trip. I was hardly 25 years. At the end of my workshop, my hostess hugged me and kissed me on my cheeks. I felt so uncomfortable. Because my first kiss. I'm used to people touching my feet. She decided, why go low? She went high. Kasam se bol raha, I felt so uncomfortable. From Blue Mountains, I went to Sydney. I shared to a German couple. I felt very uncomfortable. She kissed me. And he told me, Swamiji, she's so good looking. Why are you unhappy? Then I realized she expressed love by hugging and kissing. But my interpretation of love is you should touch the feet or say namaste. So what has hurt me, it is not her kiss. It is my interpretation. It is your narrative. It is not the situation, sir. Now, words help find. What is your interpretation? Please see this. All right? You talk, your interpretation exists. Harsh words are an insult. Or harsh words are stab on the back. Or everybody is insulting our doorman. Doorman, if your dialogue, your narrative is like this, your experience is hurt, sir. And your psychological position is pain. But if your narrative is, please see, you know, Madan Mohan Malia, all of you know, who established the Hindu Banaras University, he went to Hyderabad and the Nizam didn't like the word Hindu Banaras University. If you go to, even now, Hindu Banaras City, they have changed it because they don't want a communal slant. The original is, he went to the Nizam of Hyderabad, he didn't like the word Hindu Banaras University. He said, change the word Hindu, I'll change it. But Madan Mohan, a scholar, he explained to him, dash, dash, dash. But still he got upset. The Nizam takes the shoe and throws at Madan Mohan Malia. Now Madan Mohan Malia, he can't get it. A single shoe thrown at him, he took it out and left the palace of Hyderabad. And started auctioning the streets of Hyderabad. Nizam ka shoe hai. Nizam ka shoe. People came to know his shoe is auctioned. All right, people came. Because everything was foreign there, no? All right, then the Nizam came to know his shoe is auctioned. He sent some of the chelas to increase the price. And Madan Mohan Malia got a best price at a shoe thrown at him. Clap for him, not for me at least. A shoe thrown at him because his narrative was sakaratmak, sir. Somebody calls a monkey, I'm not a monkey. Somebody calls, it is his perception problem. It is his personal, if your guftugu, aapka man ka vartalakmak sakaratmak ko, then aapka anubhav, aapka tajurba ekdam kaam hai, aapka manostiti kya hota hai? You're in a state of power. Are you getting, sir? You're in a state of power. Are you getting this? Now, this is extraordinary, sir. This is what happened to our Prime Minister also. Are chai wala, he took that as a campaign. I took that as a campaign, sir. So first thing I think, refuse to get hurt. Because hurt is your narrative. If a woman divorces you, one person says, I want to put acid to my girlfriend. 4 years had a relationship. Are 4 years you had fun with her, no? Yes, tremendous fun, Swamiji. Are she left you. Why are you invalidated your 4 years? And have a deep trust, one door closes, another door opens. One woman goes, another woman comes. One business is closed, another business will open. Now that is a positive way of going about, no? So vision, power, all of you. Vision, power, that is extraordinary. Speed. I'll quickly run, I don't think I can cover everything. Speed, all of you, speed. Now for me, extraordinary speed is, I'll say this and maybe allow you to ask questions I'll not be able to cover. Speed is what, sir? All of you, where have you positioned happiness in the spectrum of time? Where have you positioned happiness in the spectrum of time? Huh? Baba, you're understanding my English or can I speak in Malayalam?
where have you positioned happiness in the spectrum of time? In the future, Nama, I get married, I'll become happy. The neighbor divorces, I'll become happy. Options open up. My son goes to America, I'll become happy. When I get $10 million, I'll become happy. Most of us position happiness in the future. Yes or no, sir? I have 10 factories, I'll become happy. When you say, I'll become happy in the future, silently you are telling, at present, I'm not happy. Yes or no, sir? Please. At present, I'm not happy. Now, what is time? Quickly, what is time? Past, present, and future. But what is the truth of time?
Present.
Dekho, present. Life is a journey of present, 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 present. From here, I look, it is past. When past happened, it happened as present. When the future happens, it happens as what?
Present.
$10 million, I'm going to become happy in the future. At present, I'm unhappy. So unhappy, 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 I get my $10 million. But I practice unhappiness so much, when I get $10 million, I'll say $20 million is more than $10 million. So, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani jatare shayhanam, sir. This is a story of people's life. We are practicing. Now, the greatest mutation to your brain will happen. That is extraordinary, sir. $10 million I want to have. But at present, I'm happy. I'm happy, happy, happy. Out of happiness, I go towards my $10 million. Not for happiness. Out of happiness, I get married. Not for happiness. When I practice being happy now, I get my $10 million, I say $20 million, but still out of happiness. The brain goes a tremendous mutation, sir. Or if you don't do, you will continue being miserable. You may be Elvis Presley, Michael Jackson, Marilyn Monroe. You are inside a daridrata hoga. Right? So therefore, be happy right now. Right? Or else if you don't bring this change, it is like, wo cham cham karti aayi aur cham cham karti chali gayi. Mai sindoor lekar khada raha, wo raaki bandhkar chali gayi. Yehi halat hoga. At the end of it, suddenly you find, seeing is there. Right now, be happy. If you understand myself, happy. If you don't understand, the speaker says, just be happy. How simple. Once the brain tells I'm happy, happy. Please understand, har pal mein pyar hai. Har lambe mein kushi hai. Khodo to yaad hai. Jilo to zindagi hai. Haray jilo to zindagi hai. Right? Now that is the speed. So right now be happy. Happy. Don't say $10 million I'll become happy. Before that you may die. Before that a lorry can hit you up. Suddenly can have a brain surgery. And when you are unhappy, your soul next birth also will be unhappy. So right now be happy, sir. That is extraordinary, sir. Out of happiness, earn your money. Out of happiness, sir. Vision, power, speed. Skill. I have no time to dwell on this. Skill, strategy. What should be a strategy, sir? Simple. A spiritual strategy is simplify your life. Don't complicate your life. Most of us complicate life. Have you seen people? All right, marriage, so complicated. Ultimately, they're getting divorced. So complicated, all dikawa, dikawa. Aray, simplify your life. Jeena saral hai, marna saral hai, shadi karna saral hai, talaq bhi saral hai. To mushkil kya hai? Saral hona hi bada mushkil hai. Saral hona hi bada mushkil hai. Simplify your life, sir. When you simplify your life, be simple in what? And therefore, out of simplicity you go, then you will find the purity of life opens to you when you are simple. When you're complicated, simple things become complicated. When you're simple, complicated things also become simple. So I say vision, power, speed, skill, strategy. For me, this is extraordinary, sir. And with this extraordinariness, sir, khwaish aisi karo ki aasman tak ja sako. Magar dua aisi karo ko khuda ko pa sako. You to jeene ke liye pal bahut kam hai. You don't know when you're going to die. Jeevo aisa ki har pal zindagi pa sako. Yeah, going to the bathroom, say, wow. Who knows, afterwards the bathroom also won't come. Everything pass a course, sir. When you are meeting people, you have a 3 days conference. It's the first day, isn't it? You are meeting. When you meet people, meet out of joy. I saw a beautiful movie wherein the person is caught in an island. No people. Misses the very thing. There is also a Hindi movie, what is that? Entrapped or something. Fellow gets trapped in the in an apartment and he can't come out. Somehow manage to come out. Meeting people is beautiful, sir. When you're in the conference, when you're meeting people, my God, feel you're meeting God. Zindagi phal do phal hai. Zindagi do phal. Isme nahi to aaj aur kal hai. Jilo zindagi ka is taraf. Jilo zindagi ka is taraf. Ki jo bhi aap se mile, wo yahi kahe, yahi zindagi ka sabse haseen pal hai. Whoever meets you must say, what a wonderful person. Jo bhi aap se mile, whoever meets you, he should say, you are the most beautiful person, sir. Give that energy, sir. Feel that energy. Are you getting, sir? Don't listen to that. Piles complete. Feel, sir. Kya bataun dare mehboob se kya milta hai? Kya? गजल क्या बताऊं दरे महबूब से क्या मिलता है देखने वाले नजर हो तो खुदा मिलता है नजर नजर को देखो नजर को जानो नजर है कंजल नजर है तूफान नजर मिलाना बुरी नहीं है नजर से कोई बचा नहीं है क्या बताऊं दरे महबूब से क्या मिलता है देखने वाले नजर हो तो भगवान मिलता है बाबा सो नजर से जोलो फील That and when you do that is extraordinary, sir. Then you will be beyond success, beyond failure. At present, success and failure is defining our life. At present, success and failure is defining our life, sir. When you come from this energy, you will be bigger than success and failure. You will define success. You will define failure. At ordinary is success defines you, failure defines you. All right. But if you come from this state of being, another platform. Then you define success because you are bigger than success. You are bigger than failure, sir. Then your life is going to be wonderful. All right? And for me, that coming from that vision, that power, that speed, that skill, that strategy, right? Please see, is an extraordinary way of living, sir. And Rabindranath Tagore, a simple dewdrop in a lotus leaf, poetry comes out. And there's some people, they see the most wonderful thing. Nothing happens. And like this, you get married also. Like this, you go to honeymoon also. Child comes out like this. And then he says, Swamiji, you have authored 112 books. My son is serious. What can I do? I said, manufacture is defect. What I can do? You have been so serious, sir. Aray, gambhirata ka chodo. Lachi lapan lao aapka jeevan mein. Luft le lo jeevan mein. Magar khwaish aisi karo ki aasaman tak ja sako. That extraordinary paradigm, it warrants a tremendous sagacity for this alacrity to open up in life. If you don't bring that sagacity, you may be successful, profitable. That is not a profitable growth. It is only growth. Profitable growth is bringing that state of consciousness into your being. Okay? Thank you very much. I'm sorry I'm hurrying because I respect your time. I heard 10 minutes for question answer session. Then your Madhya Pradesh, you can go. Yes, sir. Mic given. The mic will be given. I'm going very fast. It's not my usual speed.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Because I heard you are 100 speakers you have got. My God. Ray, sir.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Dhanyavadji.
One simple question. If you were not wearing orange and were wearing a... You would not be less of a Swami. Why does every Swami feel the need to wear orange? Right, or saffron?
Okay. Does this answer make a difference in your life?
It doesn't make me happy.
Ask questions which make a difference in your life. My request is, ask questions you make. Swamiji, did you have an affair or not? What type of underwear are you wearing? It doesn't make a difference. And given the limitation of 1 hour you have given, it's not a relevant question. But still I will answer you. Because I respect you. Aabru karenge aapko. Right, Hindu monks wear fire colored dress. It is symbolic. This is symbolic of fire. How fire, if you put diamond to the fire, it burns. If you put garbage, it burns. Fire is not attached. So to a monk should be committed not to be attached, to praise or censure. Because ultimately you're going to die and go. When you die, you can't even take your mustache also and go. So therefore what? So a monk, jnanagnihi basmasat kuruche. So fire is worship, be like a fire, don't be attached. You care for people, don't be attached. All right, most of us, our life is attached and therefore we are suffering. So monk carries fire. From a scientific angle, this saffron color, red color, if you study chromotherapy, it keeps you awake. It keeps you awake. So ultimately we have to be awake to our what is happening in our mind. I'm giving you a lecture. It can be a pure ego trip that I'm talking to you. It can be an ego trip. I have to be aware this lecture is an ego trip, or is the lecture is genuinely sharing understanding, or I'm a bartering understanding for your thali, for your money. I have to be aware. Are jnanam jagrataha, Lord Shiva says. Now, Christian wears white dress, it stands for purity. So, every culture has a certain tradition, ek falsafa hai, us falsafa ka anusar aap jata hai. Right? Right? So, therefore, that's the reason. But it doesn't matter. Somebody told me in Hyderabad, Swamiji, I spoke on relationship with a group of doctors in Hyderabad. And he said, Swamiji, your talk on relationship is so good, but my advice to you, if you get married, it will be better. Because you have an experience of marriage. But without experience, you have spoken so well. I said, a surgeon need not go through piles complaint to treat piles. A heart surgeon need not go to heart problem to treat heart. So I don't have to go through marriage, sir. To go through. But marriage is your choice. Right? Not getting married is my choice. Why are you crushing it in our choices? Yes, sir. Next question.
Swamiji, pranam.
Pranam ji.
A normal human being passes through good times and bad times. So when a normal person has a bad times, how exactly you advise oneself to keep upbeat in bad times and, you know, whatever he or she wants to chase should be upbeat and chasing. So what are the, you know, what are the ways?
I got a question. I'm hurrying because lack of time. That's all. Right? Because hamara jeevan bhi raftar ho gaya. I'll say. Now, I give an example of two things. One of my programs got cancelled in San Francisco. One of my organizers, she's Shakila. She organizes my abroad trips. We got cancelled. Then we went to Hawaii for a holiday. One program got cancelled. Went to Hawaii. When the waves of Hawaii is magical. When the waves came, we used to run. But people who know surfing, they're kind of romanced with those waves. We did not know surfing, so we are running away. Problems are like waves. If you know how to romance with the waves, a surfer knows how to romance. Like how when you go to roller coaster, don't we enjoy the roller coaster, most of us? Because you have decided to enjoy. But in life, there is a roller coaster you have decided not to enjoy. So I tell people, train your paradigm. Change your paradigm. Difficulty, please see, learn to enjoy. When you're doing weights, please see, right? My servant was telling me in my gym, why are you struggling, Swamiji, on this? She thinks I'm struggling. I'm enjoying my weights, even though I'm saying. So difficulties, if you change your mindset, sir, right, you will start enjoying. One, when you have a trust, sir, when you operate from self two, not self one, the interfering self, self two, every difficulty is a lesson. I say when there's a problem, sir, a problem is a great guru, is a bada ustad hai wo. Because a problem which is giving you difficulty tells you your deficiency, tells you what efficiencies or skills you should enhance. So problem is a great guru. And problem helps you to be creative. The second important dimension, sir. Third important dimension, so you treat every problem you define. It is telling you deficiency, it is telling you where you have to increase the efficiency. It's a great master to you. Third important thing, understand there's a dimension of Naseeb or Nazar. Please see, there's a Naseeb and Nazar. So, mera Naseeb hai, seventh day or sixth day, I'm in different states. Ye mera Naseeb hai. Right? I can fret and few. There is a factor of our Naseeb playing there. And therefore, I say, Nazar or Naseeb ka ittafaq dekh lijiye. Nazar or नसीब का इत्तफाक देख लीजिए. नजर को क्या चीज पसंद है आपका नसीब में नहीं है. नजर को क्या चीज, माय नजर इज आई वांट ओनली लेडीज टू बी हियर. आई एम नॉट मीनिंग इट, जस्ट एग्जांपल. मेरा नसीब में नहीं है. सो नजर को क्या चीज पसंद है आपका नसीब में नहीं है. और नसीब में लिखा हुआ चीज आपका नजर नहीं है. व्हाट इज इन योर फेट यू डोंट सी इट. In your fate, you have one wife, but the other person has four wives. That is not. Arey, one wife ko lutle lo na bhi. So therefore, if you can understand nazar or naseeb, lime is given, make a lemonade. So difficulty is a great guru, sir. All right? Please see, nobody can avoid problems of life. Problems are inevitable, but suffering is optional. Problems are inevitable, but suffering is optional. We treat problem as equal to suffering. That's the problem. See, before I used to give only talks in English and South Indian languages. When Swami Ramdev came to me and said, Swamiji, aapka Saraswati zaban mein hai, so why can't you speak to Hindi? And 7 years I started picking Hindi. So they had difficulty, but I enjoyed the difficulty. Then they said, Swamiji, aapka Hindi bahut klisht hai. Man ko prakshalan karo. Nobody understands prakshalan. They say, thoda Hindustani baat karna hai. That became another problem. See, English I was good. They put me to Hindi. I picked up Hindi fairly. Then say, Hindustani. Hindustani means what? Urdu, Hindi and English. I picked up fairly well Urdu. Then Bombay said, zyada Urdu bolta hai Swamiji. When I say Sanskrit, sir, I'm giving you as a speaker, we have difficulties. I enjoy difficulty. Your marriage will work, right? When there is difficulty, your brain should so fret. Buddha says, causelessly be happy, sir. Now, that is where the awakening should happen. But you think when problems are not there, I'm going to be happy. You should say, in spite of problems, I'll be happy. In spite of the waves, I'm going to negotiate with the waves, sir. Do that and you will see. You have to set the brain free. If you set the brain free, it'll happen. And when you have devotion, sir, you will enjoy difficulty. Ek love, there's a beautiful Urdu shayari. Ek love se mohabbat ka adna sa fasana hai, simte tu dilana aashik hai, faile to zamana hai. He says, ek love se mohabbat ka, the word mohabbat is a word. Ek love se mohabbat ka adna sa fasana hai. It is so limited and fasana hai. But ek adna sa fasana hai, simte tu dilana aashik hai. All your lover is limited to your beloved. Right, faile to zamana hai. When your love becomes devotion, are faile to zamana hai. It spread round, sir. You have to awaken that, sir. Nahi to ek love se mohabbat ka adna sa fasana hai, simte tu dilana aashik hai, faile to zamana hai. So therefore, even if you love, you will suffer, sir. That's why in Urdu, ishq nazuk mizaj hai, behat akal ka bojh utha nahi sakta. Alright, so therefore your ishq should become right bhakti, then only aap parivartan hota man ka prakshalan ho jata hai. Yes, last question.
Swamiji,
where are you?
Here.
Yes, please. Yes.
Swami, namaste.
Namaskar ji.
I have a question. I'm raising an 11-year-old, and my question for you is, how do we strike a balance between the digital age and their needs and their desires versus trying to create a balance in their life so they have a good life?
I understand this. See, it's a very important concept. There's a lack of time for me to dwell on that. But I'll still see, you have to be sensitive to this fact, you know. I want you to get this now. You see a mobile, but you don't see the electromagnetic waves of the mobile. Yes or no? You see the body, but you don't see the mind. You see the mobile, you don't see the electromagnetic waves. You see the body, the mind. As a parent, you should understand the mind plays a bigger role than just the body. That's why Kabir says, man ke hare hara hai, man ke jeete jeet. Mind. In mind, as a parent, you should understand there are many patterns playing in our mind. There is a cat pattern. Cat pattern is always being indifferent. I have no time, I'm going fast. There is a dog pattern, always needs to be appreciated. There is a snake pattern, please, he always feels threatened psychologically. And there is a fox pattern, which is always cunning. You read my book, sir, I've given this beautifully. Cat pattern is very indifferent. All right, dog pattern always needs to be patted. If you say snake, you try to give milk, it feels threatened. Fox is cunning. The mind has this cat, dog, fox, snake patterns. As a parent, your education is, right, see, be sensitive to these and put a swan pattern. It's called in Sanskrit as Hamsa Kshira Nyaya. Hamsa is a Himalayan bird, mythological word. When milk and water is taken, it takes the milk and leaves the water. As a parent, you have to give the discretion to take the good and leave the bad. And it comes in a mixture. So therefore, giving birth to a child is not enough. You have to give. Now, in Jainism, there's a word called Viveka for Jainism, is what is essential and what is not essential, you should know. Now, your technology is essential, but many things is not essential. Nowadays, people ask me to work-life balance. No, the topic should be WhatsApp and life balance. Everywhere in WhatsApp. Are what is not necessary, you're going. So you as a parent, you can't snub them. Tell them, use technology wisely. You should know what is essential, not essential. What is not essential? Most of people don't know what is essential, not essential. Most of people sleep late at 1 o'clock, 1 or 12 o'clock in the night. That has messed up your life. If you tell your children, sir, that discipline, I knock off to 10:30 or 11 o'clock maximum. Teach, this is essential. But you sleep at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, your body goes to dogs along the line. What is the use when the body goes to dogs? You have thing. So that discretion you have to teach. That's why Mahavira said, Viveka is what is essential, what is not essential. Now, you have to teach your parents not these patterns, children. Hamsa, take the good thing. Overnight, it will not happen. As Kabir says, Dheere Dheere Remana, Dheere Sab Kuch Hoi. Mali Chisi Saugada, Ritupal. Slowly, slowly you have to educate them to do that, sir. When you educate them, right, children are so smart to get it. But, all of you, please, keep your hand like this, sir. Keep your hand, all of you. Come on, don't be slow. I'll do a small game. Please see. At the count of five, I want you to clap. At the count of five, not before. Let me see how alert you are as parents. Sir, at the count of five, I suddenly may go fast. And if you do it late, I'll call you here and drag you here in front of everybody. Right. Come on, all of you. Count of five. Follow my instruction. Follow my?
Yes, sir.
At the count of five. Follow my?
Yes, sir.
At the count of five. Not before, after. 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, except for about 10 of you. Most of you clapped at 4. Why? Because you don't follow instruction, you follow action. Children don't follow instruction. Children follow action. You smoke and say, children, smoking is very bad. They put ganja on smoke. They'll innovate. You say, alcohol is bad and you go on to all your parties will have alcohol. So you should walk your talk and talk your walk. All right? And your actions should speak, sir. So these are the cycle. Please, I request you read my book. So many patterns are operating. Understand, you should tell the children, it's just not the body. Mind plays a bigger role. And mind is governed by these patterns. We call it in Hinduism, we call it samskaras. If you have a cat pattern, it'll be indifferent. If you have a dog pattern, you know, always need to be patted. If a snake pattern, always you feel threatened. If somebody says hello, you feel threatened. Why is she calling me hello? I've seen so many workshops and I look at people, they get confused. Hey, why Swamiji is looking at me? I think he has intentions. And that he comes from Bangalore. Bangalore, all Anandas come out. Just looking. And if I don't look at them, intention is not looking. Because I'm not a Brahmin. And all Brahmins are like this. Snake pattern, sir. So you have to, your work itself, bring up children, is the situations of life you should educate them. Hey, zindagi ek band kitab hai. Very few people kholkar padhta hai. Kuch kholta hai, padhta nahi. Kuch log padhta hai, samajhta nahi. Kuch log samajhta hai, wo tajurban mein nahi lata hai. Parenting is a very creative art. Right? Arman ko chodo, sankalp se aao. Aapka jeevan ekdam luft ho jata hai. But arman se jayenge, to aapka phamal ho jata hai jeevan. Yeah.
How to get out of attachment.
Right? The question, what is attachment? Attachment, please get this. Without this, I refuse to be happy. Without success, I refuse to be happy. Without my mehbooba, I refuse to be happy. Without people praising me, I refuse to be happy. Attachment which says, without this, I refuse to be happy. It is stupidity. You are limiting yourself to that. So if you tell yourself, all right, without money, without power, without position, in deep sleep, you don't have ganja, alcohol, Miss World next to you, still you are happy, no? Why are you doubtfully looking at me? You are happy. And where did that happiness come from? It has come from within you. So every night, existence gives you a trailer. You can be happy without things. When mind wakes up, the stupid mind comes up and says, without my neighbor's wife, I can't be happy. Without success, I can't be happy. This stupidity plays an important role, sir. Last, I will say, end up. Vajpayee gives a beautiful Hindi poem. Bari dupari mein andiyara, suraj parichai se hara, antartam ka nehan chode, buji hui baati sulagaye, aavo fir se diya jalaye, aavo fir se diya jalaye. It's a beautiful Hindi poem. He says, bari dupari mein andiyara. In the peak of afternoon, there is darkness. How can it be? Bari dupari mein andiyara, suraj parichai se hara. Suraj means sun is defeated by shadow. It is impossible. But still this mind has done this. Bari dupari mein andiyara, suraj parichai se hara. That's how ignorance has done. So what should you do? Antartham ka neha nichode. Antartham in the deepest of your being. Neha means sneha, nichode. Buji hui bati, the wick which is blown off. Sulaghaye, let us light it. Aavo fir se diya jalaye, aavo fir se diya jalaye. What a beautiful poem of this one. So ignorance has created havoc in our life because we have not done the homework of thinking wisely. Because some of us think, many of us think, we think, and most of us never think of thinking. Yes, sir. I only request you, read, not because I'm saying this, 15 minutes, please take time to read some good book. I'm saying my book, it can be any book, good book. 15 minutes, like brushing the teeth, like exercising half an hour, 15 minutes you do, sir, a deep cleansing happened. That's one request. Can I make that request? Second request, try to knock off before 10 o'clock, 10:30. 10:30 is knock off. Such conferences time it may go up, but as a principle, knock off. Sleep is creating a mess in our life. All right, sometimes even I'm traveling, it breaks, but knock off 10:30 and get up early in the morning. And when you sleep in the thing, you will see how much your body repays. Can I request you that too? Third, can I request you? Work for a cause beyond yourself. Don't live a selfish life. Work for a cause beyond yourself. I tell you, your soul becomes tremendously rich when you work for a cause beyond yourself. Right? Last, can I make a request? Whether you follow or not, your karma it is. My karma, last is, sir, all of you have parents? If you have parents, at least once a week, can you sit down and your wisdom of life, can you share it to your parents? Just share. I'm such a busy life. I live, even though I am a monk. Every time I go home, right, I sit, my mother says, what have you thought? I create half an hour with her and talk. My latest book, which the famous super cop has given a briefing of it, he says this covers all which is taught in the best of universities like Harvard Business School and Stanford University, he said. And this book latest, which has become so popular, is my dialogue with me and my mother. I share my understanding, she shares the understanding I brought out. Right? I've set an example in my busy schedule. If you too have your parents or some elderly person who's close, spend quality time of understanding and connect to them, sir. Do these four things and enrich your soul. Thank you very much. Namaskar, sir. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much
for you.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a big round of applause for Swami Sukhabodhananda. Thank you very much, Swamiji, for this very interesting session on transforming ordinary to extraordinary. Thank you very much, Swamiji.
And please watch my website. www means work without worry. And my name, swamisukhabodhananda.org. Many of my talks will be there and therefore spent. Thanks. It's wonderful meeting all of you.
God may I request you to kindly remain on stage, sir, for 1 minute. And may I request Mr. Didi Prakash, the Managing Director and CEO, ABP Private Limited and Chairman Infocom, to kindly come forward and present a memento to Swami Sukhabodhananda. Thank you very much, Swamiji.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
For this highly motivational session.
Thank you very much, sir.
On transforming the ordinary to the extraordinary.
Nowadays, it's all computer to write books.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you wish to buy Swamiji's books, they are available at a counter outside this hall. They are also available online at www.prasannatrust.org. And if you want specialized messages, personalized messages from Swamiji, then you can log on to www.prasannatrust.org. So you can actually connect to him. Thank you very much, Swamiji.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank
Your
you,
voice
sir.
Is wonderful.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.